some good morning. Ha, as I told you yesterday also, that government of India started Khelo India program. So these are the main objectives: talent search, physical fitness, state level Khelo India, sports for women. Few more are there that you will come to you can find by yourself. If you have any doubt, you are most welcome. If that question comes, what is the objective of Khelo India program? Talent search. It has to search the talent from the grassroots level, or you can say from the school level. If you are able to find the students from the school level only, you can bring the best out of them when they will be at their peak. So you should give them training from the earliest level. You can't say, for example, when you are studying from KG only, you have to teach the students. You can't say, okay, from in class 12 we will start learning ABCD. No, for talent search, from the particular age is there, for example, class 4 to 6, when you should go for talent hunt, and afterwards you can find out which student is good in which sports. According to the interest of the student, you can make them play that particular game. So these are few of the objectives of physical education that we have learned yesterday also. But if the question comes, what are the objectives? Just write 2 or 3 lines about two to three lines by yourself in your own words. Physical fitness of students. Physical fitness of students means they should be physically fit. They should have all the health related fitness components in their body. And like, for example, what the CBSE is conducting for class 5th to 11th is AFA test. AFA test is conducted. For me, a short form is AAPHER, AAHPER, American Alliance for Health, Physical Education and Recreation. There are few tests that are created to measure the different fitness components of an individual. Like you are supposed to run 600 meter run. Why we are running 600 meter run? To measure your endurance, how much endurance you are having. And then 100 meter dash or 50 meter dash. What is that? You are measuring your speed. So there are different fitness component in your body that are measured by different tests designed by the great physical educators. They were designed a much long time back, but now till now for any qualifying exam, these are tests that you have to pass. After that only you are eligible to go for the written exam and all that. So CBSE has also made it compulsory that for like class 1 to 4, they are different tests like flamingo test and all that. These students have to do their test. But from class 5th or 6th to class 11th, the students have to undergo AFA test. There are 5 to 6 test items in AFA test, which a student have to go. So for example, in class 7th, we are measuring conducting AFA test for a student. And his speed is coming 13 seconds, 50 meter, 100 meter, 30 seconds in class 7th. That will be updated to the website of CBSE. In class 8th, again the test will be conducted for that individual, and then we have to see whether his physical fitness is improving or deproving. After that, according to it only, we will be assigned, we have to update the CBSE website, and the CBSE will come to know, okay, how the students are performing, what is the level of fitness of that individual in the school. Then one topic was different tournaments at national level and international level. See, it's very easy. Any game you choose. For example, if you are choosing ICC cricket, then it comes Ranji Trophy, Irani Trophy, and IPL. But when it comes to international, then you first of all, any cup conducted by that international association should be written first. Like ICC World Cup. After that comes Asia Cup. So these are some of the national tournaments and international tournaments that you have to see. And this is an example for cricket. Now for example, now we are seeing for any other tournament, like you can say hockey, you can say football. Football will be starting national games is generally called Olympics of India, because every tournament is conducted in the national games. Like Olympics, national game is also conducted at a span of 4 to 5 years gap. Last year it was conducted in 2015. Before that it was conducted in 2011 or 12. Like Maharashtra, after that it came to Kerala. Now it is due in Uttarakhand or Goa. So it was due in 2020 starting only, but due to pandemic it has been postponed. This year it was in October, I think July or August it was due. So national games. After that comes, for example, we are going for football. Then comes senior national trophy, senior national championship, senior national championship for that particular game. For men and women, you can say Santosh Trophy, any other trophy like that. You can write the name of the trophy also. For international, it will be same way, international association, that is what is FIFA, Federation International Football Association. It is a French word, Federation de Internationale Football Association. World Cup. Then comes FIFA Asia Cup. Or you can say, if you're conducting among the America country, it comes Copa, Euro. So these are the examples you have to see. Okay, these are the different types of tournament that will be conducted by at the national level as well as at international level. So if the question comes, what are the different tournaments conducted at national level or international level, particular game, first of all write national game except cricket. National games, Olympics of India. After that comes senior national championship for men and women. Same way, association linked with World Cup, FIFA for football, for basketball it becomes FIBA, for ICC it becomes ICC World Cup, T20 World Cup. These are all the international trophies conducted by international associations. Now we will be starting with our new chapter. Chapter 1 is over. That we have completed our four topics. That first one was that meaning and definition of physical education. After that comes different careers in physical education. You can write the careers, but as well as you should be able to write what are the physical qualifications that are required for that particular job. You can't say that anyone can become a teacher for teaching a subject. No, like B.Ed is compulsory for teaching a subject for class 11th and 12th. B.Sc. and B.Ed is compulsory for teaching till class 10th. But for teaching class 11th and 12th, you should be M.Sc. Like that way, you should be P.G. or U.G. That the if you are knowing the qualification, it is well and good. After that came, what is different types of tournament conducted by different associations or different championship conducted by at national level and international level. And Khelo India program. What is the aim and objectives? What are the future prospects? And what is Khelo India program? Now we are starting with Olympic movement. Chapter 2. What is Olympics? I think everyone of you might be knowing that Olympic is the biggest sporting event in the world. It is like a festival for the sports person. It is like a festival for the sports person. Similarly, like Asian Games also, but in Asian Games, the countries from the Asian continent is only participating. But here, if it comes to Olympics, the countries from all over the world, they are participating in Olympic Games. It is a big festival. It is a big sporting event, or you can say it is a festival for the sports person, where they are meeting with different people of different countries, different caste, different religion, and all that. So it is a big festival for the sports person. Basically, you can divide the Olympic Games into two. Ancient Olympic Games / modern. Ancient Olympic Games. When was the Ancient Olympic Games conducted? It was in the year 776 BC. And when modern Olympic Games started, it is in the year 1896. It was also started in Athens, Greece, and the first modern Olympic Games were conducted in Athens, Greece only. What was the aim earlier? Who used to participate? There is a different history regarding ancient Olympic Games. Who used to participate? What were the different events that were held in ancient Olympic Games? First of all, there was only one race, running on the foot. After that came pentathlon. There were few events that were included afterwards, but no slave was allowed to participate in ancient Olympic Games, and there were no medal and anything was provided. Only olive crown was given to the winner. Like in modern Olympics, if you are seeing, like in Athens when it was conducted, olive branch crown was given to the winner. After that, now medals have replaced that. Everything. So there is a big change in modern Olympic Games and ancient Olympic Games. That time it only the Athens people were participating in it. Now, no slave and no other person from outside was allowed to participate. So we will be dealing what is ancient Olympic Games, what is the history of ancient Olympic Games, what is the what is modern Olympic Games, when it was started and who started it, who is called the father of the modern Olympic Games. So, you just find out. Remaining, I will tell you tomorrow. Now, different topics are there. That what is IOA, IOC? You might have heard about what is IOC, International Olympic Committee, IOA, Indian Olympic Association. What is the duties? What are the objectives that will be taught in this chapter? Now comes Ancient duties of IOC and IOA. There two other things are there: IOC, IOA, and IOC. National body. A national body governing Olympic, that is IOA, Indian Olympic Association, and international governing body of Olympic, that is International Olympic Committee. Now, there is an Olympic symbol. I think you might be knowing that there are five rings in Olympics. Olympic flag. 1, 2, 3. So this is called Olympic symbol. Now, these are not white in color. It is on white flag, but these are in different colors like black, yellow, red. They represent a particular thing that you have to find out and write in your copy. I will also tell you, but tomorrow if you are able to write what is the symbol of Olympic flag and what does these rings represent. They are generally there are five different color rings in the flag. White flag, it is generally for peace, but different rings, they represent different rings of different colors. They represent a particular thing that you have to find out and write in your copy. This is the homework for you. Now, simply there is an oath for Olympic Games. After that comes what is Olympic motto. What is Olympic motto? Generally, whenever tournament is conducted, just a bird or animal of that particular place is taken as an Olympic motto. Olympic emblem, or you can say Olympic motto, like that. When Asian Games were conducted, it was Appu. When Commonwealth Games were conducted, it was Shera in India. Similarly, whenever anything is conducted, a particular motto or emblem is given for that tournament. Olympic is conducted in a city. Most important, Olympic is not conducted in a country like World Cups. World Cup that is conducted in the countries, but Olympic is conducted in a city. Like this year, it was supposed to be held in Tokyo. World Cup football was held in Russia. Different cities will be involved in conducting the World Cup. But Olympics were, if you are saying that Asian Games also, particular city will be involved in conducting that particular game. Olympics like Tokyo, next one is in Paris. Last one was conducted in, I think so. Last one was in, not remembering right now. So these are the cities are being given the provision to conduct the tournament for that particular event. Olympics is conducted in cities as well as Asian Games, and this World Cups are conducted in the countries. Like if you have seen 2020 World Cup, it was supposed to be held in Australia. Different cities will be held, but cities and countries, these are different with Olympic and World Cup. Now similarly, you can say different, many games are conducted in Olympic Games as well as in Asian Games. Almost same are like athletics is there, basketball is there, that will be dealing tomorrow. So father of the modern Olympic Games, when was the modern Olympic Games started? It was started in 1896. In Athens. Who is the father? Baron Pierre de Coubertin. That I will tell you tomorrow. So, there are a few topics that we have to cover under this chapter. Olympic. What are the Olympic values that you learned? In Olympics, like brotherhood, it comes. Friendship, because different athletes from different countries are coming. And you become friends with them. So friendship, solidarity, peace, no caste and creed. Because different religion, different people, different caste, different people, they are coming to participate in that Olympics. So these are the values that you are learning from them. And you are also teaching them. So brotherhood, solidarity, peace. So these are the values that are learned through Olympic Games. That you will be dealing tomorrow. So tomorrow we'll be starting our new chapter, Olympic Movement. What was ancient Olympic Games? When it was conducted? Where it was conducted? After that, when modern Olympic Games started? So this is a history of ancient Olympic Games as well as modern Olympic Games. When it was conducted? Where it was conducted? That we'll be dealing tomorrow. So we are starting with our new chapter, Olympic Movement, tomorrow. Okay, dear students, thank you very much. One minute. I will be in your YouTube box when you are seeing the video. Just write your name and class, so that your attendance can be marked in that. No other comment. Only your name and class and section. That so that your attendance will be marked. Okay, dear students. Thank you.